In previous videos we have seen the default parameters and default behavior of yarn. So here we will be doing the tuning part. So tuning is nothing but defining or changing certain parameters at the yarn level so that it will effectively utilize the existing resources. So in yarn you have seen the term container, which is nothing but the combination of CPU and memory. So we use the term vCore, which is nothing but a usage share of CPU. So there will be different jobs running as in yarn. Some require more memory and some require more or less CPU share. So we have to define in yarn in such a way that this usage does not keep any idle resources. So we will see that in detail here. So this is my cluster. And here I have a if I go to the resource manager and resource manager UI and 3 gig and 6 vCore, but I can execute only 3 container at a time this year. So for tuning yarn, just go to the Google, then yarn tuning Cloudera, just search that and open the first link, yarn tuning guide. So here it's explained how the yarn work. So what is a container and what is the vCore, etc. Just take a look at this part at least once and you can see the container. So container, the yarn is assigning certain vCore and memory to some process. So that is used for executing application master, map job or reduce jobs. And also different container require the processing capacity in different way. Some require more CPU and some require more vCore and some mix of these two. And we have to define our containers in yarn such a way that there won't be any idle resources, or idle resources has to be very minimal. Right, and there is a spreadsheet available, so you can make use of that and add your values and get the parameters for tuning. Just open that spreadsheet. So once it is downloaded, okay, so this is a file, just open that. And here, so the first page you have to fill your values. So how much RAM you have, okay? So in my case I have 8 gig RAM and CPU is 2. And the next part is the worker host planning. Okay, so the next part we will define how much core and how much memory you want to allocate for other applications. For operating system, so it is recommended 8 gig, but I don't have much memory here, so I'm using 1024. And for task overhead I am not using anything because I am not going to execute much more application here. And okay, so this is my available resources, 4 gig. And CPU core also I don't have much for allocating to other, but in real production environment, so you need to be careful and allocate some share to these processes. And how many number of worker nodes you have? So I have 3 worker node. So if you want to go to the host details, just go to the host and all host, and you can see those all details. What is the core, what is the physical memory, etc. And make a note of these entries. So I have 8 gig available here. So once you added those values, just go to the yarn configuration and here you will get that value. So these values you need to add it in your yarn configuration. Just open that Cloudera manager, yarn, then configuration, then search this one. So this is 1 gig, but this one you need to change it to the value as per your documentation. Sorry, one it's 4. Sorry, I think the I selected the vCore or memory. So the memory is 4 gig and vCores. So So this is 4. Then save these changes. Next, some other values we need to change. So this is yarn scheduler minimum allocation V core. That is 1 as per the document. Then this is showing yarn hyphen, but it is supposed to be yarn dot. Yarn hyphen, there is no parameter. Right, that is 2. I'm changing to 1. Saving those changes one by one if I am making any changes. And V core increment, that is also 1. So the first part. So this is yarn node manager resource CPU V core and memory. So these are the values or available for node manager. Okay, how much CPU and how much memory we are allocating for node manager. So these are those values. And for each container, how much V core we are allocating. So what is the maximum V core we are allocating and increment. But here I am allocating only 1. And this for a scheduler minimum allocation for a container. So what is a minimum allocation? This is 1 gig, and the maximum allocation. So maximum allocation is 1 gig, so that I can change it to 8 gig. Then save that change. Then increment 512 MB. Yes, correct. So next we'll go to the other details. Okay, so here it's everything is showing good. So if it is showing in an amber or other any error or anything, so you need to take a look back to the values you have added. So this is are the values we need to add here. And the second, go to the MapReduce configuration. So these values you need to change. Do it here, and that is 1, and this value, how much? So that is 1, yes, 1 gig, and this value, so that is 1, correct? So this MB. So that is 1, has to be 1 gig, 0, it is showing a 0, just change to 1 gig, and I think this value we need not to do. Java heap size is already set, it's not there, and this value, this is 1. So similarly, you have to choose all this one. Changing those parameter and Java option map reduce. So this has to be 1024. Okay, so that is no need to do. And IO sort MB 256. So some are already there in the default. So some values we need to change. So these are the changes we need to do. So map reduce configuration and yarn values we need to change. So that's it. And save those values, and after saving, so we need to restart the trail services. Just click that restart and redeploy whatever the values. So I have restarted the service, right? So yarn is restarted. Then go to the yarn resource manager web interface. So now you can see 12 gig RAM and 12 V core. That means 4 gig from each worker machine and 4 V core from each machine. So if you just go and look into this parameter, and we can see the whatever the parameters we have changed and its details. So yarn node manager resources and these two. So these are the container memory per host or per worker host, how much memory we are allocating, and how much weak core we are just giving to yarn for allocating to its resources. I mean, from worker machine, so we are allocating so this much weak core and this much memory to yarn. So this will be multiplied into total number of hosts. So here, so node manager weak core we have given 4 and we have 3 worker machine, so 4 into 3, so that is why we are getting the 12 value here. So this is the old configuration, it was 3 and 6, but the new configuration is 12, right? So these two are very important. So this will control how much memory and core we can allocate to node manager. And for container, so how, what is the minimum allocation weak core and what is the maximum allocation weak core and what is the increment? See, if for a container initially it will allocate whatever the minimal, and if it require more then it will increment like this. Say for example, initially it will give 1 gigram and 1 core, something like that, and but if it require much more and increase that, and that can go till this maximum limit. And also the increment means for each step how much it can increment. Similarly, we have for memory also the minimal and the maximum allocation and the increment. For map reduce also we have some parameters like what is the map and reduce task memory and vcores options and IO sort memory, etc. So these are the configurations we need to look into while tuning the yarn. But Cloudera provides a spreadsheet. You can use that and populate your value. So the first page you can add your values, like what is your current configuration. This is for one host or one worker host, so you need to consider only your worker host where your node manager is running. So no need to consider master or other supporting servers here. So choose and use the hardware configuration. So this is the configuration of my one of my master, or all my masters are in the, I mean one of, not master, one of the worker machine. So all the worker machine I am assuming in the same configuration. So RAM and CPU, that is the total disk. And then next, for other services, how much core and how much memory we need to use. And again, the physical to weak core, there is a multiplication factor we can set here, so that even though if you have one core, you can multiply and make it into 4. I mean, per you mean to say for per CPU you are okay to do the 4 jobs or 4 weak core. And this is about, I mean, this is the value we are giving per host or per worker node. So per worker node, 4 CPU you are ready to provide and 4 gig. And the total number of worker machine we can define here, and this will give you the yarn configuration. Copy and paste it, the value in the yarn configuration, and save that and do a restart. So you need to change some of the map reduce configurations also. So the detailed descriptions are written here, and you can just go through this documentation at least once. Now we have 12 gig RAM and 12 vcores available for submitting the job. So let's try to submit the job with a couple of users and see how much it can use. Okay, so I need to just log in and try submit the jobs. Okay, so I'm going to submit a job here. Okay, so this is a sample MapReduce job which is available along with this distribution. So I use Hadoop jar, whatever the jar file, and so the I'm calculating the value for pi, and this is a sample example code available. So this jar file provides a lot of option to do the sample MapReduce job. To execute a MapReduce job, you need to use Hadoop jar command, then submit that. So here, number of mappers and the sample per mapper I can restrict. So the job has started, and if I go to the resource manager UI, and I can see it's in accepted state. Yes, it is running. So now you can see it is using around 12 containers. So out of 12, so one will be for application master, and the 11 it is used for running map or reduce tasks. We can go in detail about that job. Okay, so I'll have to use this IP address since I'm using Amazon AWS. So some of the local IP won't work here, right? So 40 maps has completed and the running job details, right? So 10 are running. So even though if it is using 11 containers, so 10 map jobs are running, one for application master. So this is how it is running, and 12 mappers are, I mean the 12 jobs are running. So if I execute the same job here, oh my god, one second, let me copy the string which I use. Okay, so this is completed. Okay, so let me, this is a bit fast. So submit this job, and earlier only one job was able to submit because of resource unavailability. So if I submit the second job, okay, the first job was submitted, and I can submit the second job also. So the first, we'll see the status again here. So this has completed and this is running with the two. So let me execute the same job with some other user, Hadoop, and okay, so it is doing the pre-processing and they're just starting. So we'll see that status here. It is in accepted state. Slowly, it will also get resources. Okay, so the second job, Hadoop 2 has submitted. That is also started running. So if I refresh that, so almost getting the same resources and running. So now in this case, we have it's almost, there is not much underutilized resources available. So we have 12 vcore and 12 gig RAM, so it can use for containers. So this is how we can tune the yarn. Okay, so just go to the Google and get this link and download that spreadsheet and populate the values and change that. I hope you were able to follow me. So if you have any doubts, so please use the comment box. Also subscribe my channel to get more updates. Thank you. Bye.